And now, it's time for another Dice Tower Review with Tom Vasel.
Hey folks, today we're taking a look at Aladdin and the Magic Lamp. This is a game from the Tales and Games series. They all look like books. They're all done by IELLO. They're kind of marketed at kids, although they're not just kids' games. Well, some of them are, but some of them are good for everyone. This is a light kind of outthink other people, push your luck, speed a little bit game. A little bit of a few things in it. It's all about Aladdin finding that magic lamp. I really want that magic lamp, but that genie would do something crazy. I'd say, give me a good game, and he'd give me a good game, but the rules would be gone or something. Ah, I hate these genies. Everybody who plays the game is going to start with a starting treasure, which is one of these different types of jewels. Each player is also going to get a small cardboard thing that matches the three pile of chests in the middle, copper, silver, gold, and you will get a purple die. On a round, a player is going to take the die and pick any number they want and place it in one of these secretly. So maybe I'll say silver. This means I want to draw four cards from the silver treasure chest. So each person is going to pick a number. If two people pick the same number, so here, for example, I picked the four and this person picked the four, then we have to summon the genie as fast as we can by slapping the table, hitting the magic lamps. The first person to do so will summon the genie. They'll turn over the top card. So this says, I'm under the sorcerer's spells. Give one of your cards to another player. Cannot be a talisman or a card from a complete set of jewelry. I don't want to do that. That's fine. You don't have to take the first card. You can take another one instead. Move any player's die to another chest without changing the value. I don't want to do that one either. So now I can draw a third one, but when you do the third one, you have to do it no matter what it is. I caught a nasty cold in the caves. Make another wish if you can. All right, fine. I'll make another wish if I can. Draw the top card of the silver chest. Ignore scorpions on this card. Great. I get this card. It has two scorpions, but I ignore those. Okay, so that was the wish. Now, we're going to start with the copper chest. Nobody put a die in the copper chest. We go to the silver chest. I'm the only person, so I get to draw four cards from the silver chest, or up to four. So I draw this one. This is a diamond. That's great. However, it has three scorpions on it. If I draw scorpions equal to or exceeding the number I roll, I'm busted. Well, that's four, and I already have three. You know what? I'll just draw one more card. Boom! Busted. So I don't get anything, and that's how that works. Now we go to the gold one. Gold has a two and a four. Since they both put there, only one person's going to draw from the gold chest, and it's going to be the person with the lower number. So gold draws this one. No scorpions. We're fine. Gold draws this one. Bust it. Boom. No one got anything this round. But let's say this time, well, bust it still. Eventually, you will get stuff that you can keep in front of you, and you're collecting these to score points at the end of the game. Now, if two people put the same number, let's say that all three of us went to the same spot. Gold, 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 and we both put twos and fours. The twos would actually cancel each other out, then the four would get it, and they would be able to draw cards. So this is going to continue, and in the bottom cards of each deck, there is a sorcerer card. When this is drawn from any of the three decks, that is going to be the end of the game. Players are going to get points. Now, what do you get points for? Whoever has the most of each of the four major types of stones is going to get five bonus points. So getting a lot of the same stone is a winner, but you're also trying to get jewelry. In each pile, by the way, these are wilds, in each pile there are different types of jewelry. These jewelry are worth nothing by themselves, but if you get a complete set, which is the tiara, the necklace, and the ring of this type here, you get 6 points. If you get the kind from the silver set, they're 8 points. If you get the kind from the gold set, the gold rings and such, you will get 10 bonus points. Every card you have is worth 1 point also, so you're going to add all these points together, and whoever has the most points is the winner of the game. Now, you can also play with the My Precious variant, which means if you draw from a chest with a six, which can be, you know, hard to do, and you draw all six cards without having too many scorpions, you get the magic ring. All right, when you get the magic ring, you get to take a card from the discard pile, cards that other people have messed over, And also at the end of the game, this is worth 5 points. That's how you play. So Yellow always makes great artwork, and this game is no exception. It's about collecting things. A few minor quibbles about production. I really wish that the sets of cards, the bonuses that they were worth, had been printed on them. That would have been a minor thing. Having to look up in the rule book to see how much each set was worth was, I don't know, I just wish they had been printed on the cards. And also, dice. Now, you know me, I love dice. These aren't very good dice, actually. They're too light. Now, you're not rolling them, so I guess that's fine, but I don't know, they're okay. Now, the game itself. The game itself is a fun, entertaining game. I think I would actually say it's a great game, with the exception, I think there's maybe one too many things going on in here. It's just the slightest bit clunky, but it's still a lot of fun. Because what you're doing is you're hiding with your hand, you know, where you're going to go. I like that. You're trying to outthink everybody else. You're like, the gold stuff's the best, but I think everyone else is going to go for gold stuff, so I'll go for copper. No, wait, they're thinking that. All right, silver, but no one's thinking that. But if I do go for silver and someone else goes for it, I want the lowest number. So there's that thought process. That's good. Then you reveal the dice, and suddenly there's a speed part to the game. That's okay. Now, that speed part is not as much happening, and it hardly ever happens in a two-player game, or in a three, but definitely four and five, it happens pretty much every round. And drawing these things, first of all, they're cool, have cool-shaped cards like this. You're going to get bad ones every once in a while. Some of them are actually pretty mean. Like you saw the one that I showed in a review where you can move someone's die somewhere else. You can literally make someone else get nothing this turn. They had, like, let's say they were a four in gold. Someone else has a six in gold. That person was about to win that. You move them over to silver where someone has a three. Now they get nothing. Some little bit of meanness in these. And, of course, there's that speed element to the game. The whole game isn't about speed, but it's there a bit. Then, once you decide who goes in, and I really like this, right? I like that this is a mechanism that's used in a few games, but this game does a cool thing with it. A really cool thing with it. In fact, I'd like to see this kind of build into a bigger, cooler game, where the lower person gets to go through the deck. Fine. That's the kind of, you know, back and forth. You're like, should I put a one? If I put a one, I'm definitely going to go first unless I tie somebody else, maybe a two. And then the person six, if no one else goes there, I get six. But if anyone else puts a die there, I get nothing unless they tie, which probably won't happen. That's cool, but you'll find that in games like this, most of the time people just get lower and lower and lower because I'd rather get something than nothing. But this game counters that with when you draw those cards, if you draw scorpions equal to or above your number, you're going to bust and get nothing. Well, now suddenly you're like, I don't know if I want to play a one because so many cards in the deck will just simply bust me, and that's worthless. So maybe I should play a two. I don't know, they still could buzz me. How about a three? And so that really counterbalances putting the dice out there, and I like that. It's a good mix there. So all that comes together, collecting the stuff. You know, every card you get is good, but you want to collect sets of gems. You want to collect sets of jewelry, and there's wild cards that are useful to collect. And I like all that. Like I said, there might be one too many things going on here, but still I think it's a lot of fun. It's fun for kids, fun for adults, and it's quick. It's a very quick game. So you play it, you're like, oh, that's pretty interesting. Let's try it again. And it works that way. Everyone I've played it with has enjoyed it. It's a worthy thing to the line. It does give you a little bit of that flavor of Aladdin. And like all these games, if that's not enough, it comes with a little storybook of Aladdin and the Magic Lamp, which I will read to you now. No, I won't. It's time to finish this review. Check this one out. Dice Tower Judgment approved.
Thanks so much for watching the Dice Tower videos. Find more great videos and reviews, as well as our top-rated audio podcast at Dicetower.com. You can also find other great shows at Dicetowernetwork.com. I'm Eric Summerer, and you've been watching the Dice Tower. The Dice Tower is sponsored by Cool Stuff, Inc., where you can find great games for great prices. Cool stuff in stock. Check them out at CoolStuffInc.com.
Shut the door!